Good morning, students. In the previous lecture, we studied about the scope of political theory. In today's lecture, we will study about the relationship between theory and practice. Relationship between theory and practice. How to transform theory into practice? Putting political theory into practice needs an analysis of social reality. For example, to understand India's social reality, we should take into account factors such as caste, community, religion, and the poverty of the masses. Our constitution lists a number of rights: right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, and the right to freedom of religion, which is a important rights of India's secular polity. Let us study how effective these rights are. First challenge is this: right to equality does not guarantee equal opportunity. An opportunity is a situation that makes it possible for you to do something that you want to do, but physical or material disabilities may cause difficulties and problems for a particular group of society. Equality before law, for instance, is a cherished ideal, but everybody knows that because of court fees and excessive fees charged by the lawyers, and the poor have no access to the law courts. So, at the time of practical situation, sometime, not always, remember this, sometime these political theories are not applicable in the practical situation. Second point, rights of the children. Violence against children is so universal that no country should ignore it. Many countries, including India, have ratified the Convention on the Rights of the Child, but the measures taken by government to translate these rights into social reality have been inadequate, or we can say not sufficient, or not in the reaching of all the children of the country. In the last of this topic, we can conclude with the fact that it is not sufficient to pass legislation aimed at establishing equality in education, employment, and other areas of human activity, but more drastic measures are required if progress in real terms has to take place in the short term. I hope this point is clear to you. And now we will move on another topic, that is the example or conversation based on Socrates and his disciple. In our book, in the first chapter, the conversation between Socrates and Cephalus is given, and you must read full conversation of these two personalities. Socrates was the great philosopher of political theory from Athens. All of you know the origin of political theory was considered from Athens, and Athens was a state in Greek country. In present time, we know Greek country, and the Athens was the state of Greek country, and Socrates belonged from this state, and Socrates' student was Aristotle. Plato. Socrates' student was Plato, and Plato was too much devoted towards Socrates. Socrates was crucified by the rulers. You can read in the first paragraph of this conversation, because Socrates told to the people about the right facts regarding the politics. So the rulers of their time sentenced to death Socrates. So his student Plato thought about his mentor's ideology, and he wrote a book that is Republic. So the important book, which is considered the most important book of political theory, was written by Plato, who was student of Socrates. And in this book, Plato had given the theory of political regarding the politics, and the concept was justice. What is justice and how we can attain justice? In this conversation, Plato explained that his mentor Socrates were giving the speeches or answer of different persons or different students regarding the justice, but at the time of conclusion, he said that this is not wise, for it is not true if as has been clearly shown, the injuring of another can be no case just. I agree with said polem. Finally, the discussion was concluded on this point. As students, we enjoy debate and elocution competitions. We have opinions about what is right or wrong, just or unjust, but do not know whether they are reasonable or not. Only when we argue with others, we realize the need to defend them and seek out reasons and arguments. Political theory exposes us to systematic thinking on just or equality so that we can polish our opinions and argue in an informed manner and for the sake of common interests. Such skills of debating rationally and communicating effectively are likely to be great assets in the global informational order. I hope all the points are clear to you. Thank you and have a nice day.